Hey everyone, it's Justin and Mia again. We've gotten to know many of Mia's relatives through our math fact units, and today we're meeting up with Aunt Twyla and her service dog Abby in Boulder, Colorado for our final set of facts. Boulder is known for its amazing stargazing opportunities, and Twyla recommended this location specifically. They should both be here soon. Remember, Mia, Abby's a medical alert service dog who's trained to let Twyla know when she needs to take special steps to stay healthy. It's important to give Abby space so she can focus on Twyla. Yeah, you can wave to Abby when she gets here, but we don't want to call her name or try to get her attention. We need to let her do her job while we focus on ours. Mastering our math facts. Twyla also happens to be Felix's sister, which means she's Bree's aunt too. Bree helped us with our threes, Uncle Felix helped us with our sixes, and today Aunt Twyla is going to help us with our 12s. Ooh, here they come. Hi, Twyla. A telescope, what a great idea. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to make connections to help you confidently multiply and divide by 12. Have your guide and notes ready, and let's reach for the stars. Aunt Twyla left us with some warm-up problems to solve while she finishes setting up the telescope. Pause here to solve 3 times 7, 6 times 7, 12 times 7, 24 divided by 3, 24 divided by 6, and 24 divided by 12 in your guided notes. Ooh. Twyla, is that the constellation Orion the Hunter? Nice. That line of stars in the middle is known as Orion's Belt. Finding those 3 stars first can make it a bit easier to see the rest of the constellation. All right, let's check our answers. 3 times 7 equals 21, 6 times 7 equals 42, and 12 times 7 equals 84. While 24 divided by 3 equals 8, 24 divided by 6 equals 4, and 24 divided by 12 equals 2. Noticing any patterns with these multiplication equations? And the division equations, notice anything familiar there? This is reminding me of the fact family work we did with Grandpa Nate when we discovered that the 2s, 4s, and 8s fact families are all related. Of course, 12s are related to 6s and 3s, like how Twyla is Felix's sister and Bree's aunt. With Grandpa Nate, we learned that knowing our 4s means we can double our product to help us multiply by 8, or split our quotient in half to help us divide by 8. And we learned that if we're not quite sure about our 4s, we can also use our 2s. That's because 2, 4, and 8 share a double and half relationship. Doubling 2 equals 4, while doubling 4 equals 8. And splitting 8 and a half equals 4, while splitting 4 and a half equals 2. Let's apply this to our 12s. Half of 12 is 6, right? And half of 6 is 3. We can use our 6s and even our 3s to help us with our 12s, because these numbers share that same double and half relationship. In your guided notes, try using related facts to help you solve 12 times 9 and 60 divided by 12. Since 12 is twice as much as 6, we can use 6 times 9 to help us solve. If you know 6 times 9, then you can double that and have your answer to 12 times 9. But if you're not quite sure about 6 times 9, you could also do 3 times 9 first. 3 times 9 equals 27. We can double that to help us solve 6 times 9. 27 and 27 is 54. Then we can double that to help us with 12 times 9. 54 and 54 is 108. That means 12 times 9 equals 108. And 60 divided by 12? Well, 60 divided by 6 equals 10. So that means 60 divided by 12 is half that amount, or 5. Just like finding the three stars in Orion's belt can help you find the rest of the Orion constellation, related fact families can help you find the answers you don't know yet. Who knew fact families and the night sky would have so much in common? Another constellation? Excellent. Ooh, following the stars from Orion's belt will lead to Sirius, the second brightest star in the sky. And Sirius is part of the Canis Major constellation, which translates to the greater dog. Huh. I could kind of see a dog-like shape if I use my imagination, but I feel like there are some pieces missing. Hey, there are some pieces missing from these problems, too. Ah, Twyla started solving them using the partial product strategy and wants us to finish them. Let's check out the first problem together. 12 times 4 shows 10 times 4 equals 40, and something times 4 equals something. Remember, the partial product strategy is a way to solve more complex multiplication problems by breaking down a factor into smaller parts and then multiplying each part by the other factor. So since Twyla multiplied 10 by 4, what else needs to be multiplied by 4? These amounts should add up to the factor you're breaking down. Since 10 plus 2 equals 12, that other piece must be a 2. And then 2 times 4 equals 8. What do we do now that we have these partial products? Add them together to find the total. 40 plus 8 equals 48, which means 12 times 4 equals 48. The next problem has a bit more missing. Looks like we're solving 12 times 12. And so far, we have 10 times 12 equals something, and then a blank multiplication sentence. Try using the partial product strategy to finish solving 12 times 12 in your guided notes. You can also look back at your work from the previous problem if you need help. You may have solved this in a slightly different order, and that's totally okay. I like to figure out the problems I need to solve first. We have 10 times 12, so what still needs to be multiplied by 12? 2. Now we have 10 times 12, which equals 120, and 2 times 12, which equals 24. Adding these partial products together will give us our final total. 120 plus 24 equals 144. So 12 times 12 equals 144. Great work, mathematicians. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that Twyla and Abby are a talented team and terrific at teaching 12s? Well, now you know that 3s, 6s, and 12s are related fact families. Multiplying by 12 is the same as multiplying by 6 and doubling the product, while dividing by 12 is the same as dividing by 6 and splitting the quotient in half. You also know that the partial product strategy can be used to multiply by breaking the problem down into smaller parts. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice multiplying and dividing by 12. Thank you for showing us these constellations and helping us with our 12s today, Twyla. You're right, Mia. Just like how each star in a constellation connects to reveal a bigger picture, every math fact we master helps us make connections and figure out solutions to bigger problems. Oh yeah! Mathematicians, this was our final fact family. Our next lesson is a practice opportunity to review 11s and 12s together before our big family reunion and fact family wrap-up lesson. Always remember, in math, as in life, practice makes progress. I'll see you next time. Hey.